What is up, guys? B here, back with another video, and today we are going to be doing a BeamNG drive versus video, which is going to be the Gravel D versus the ROAMER. Alright, so we got a couple tests lined up today. So obviously we got to do a suspension test, and we're going to start off with the ROAMER here. So, alright. First, we're gonna start with this one right here. I feel like it's gonna do it no problem. Kind of on an angle, but we can just adjust it a little bit. Look at that suspension working. I'm in the wrong camera angle. There we go. Look at that. I can't stop too on the See how it stops real time. Oh yeah. Now on to the mud. A little bit of mud. All right. And then the final test. Now I don't expect each truck to survive this, but you know, we're gonna see how far each of them can make it. Now I'm pretty sure they're the same height all the way through, so let's kinda back it up, get it going, let's say 8 times slow motion, because we want the full slow motion. Well, 4 times here. Alright, here we go. Oh, the suspension just like, ooh, but it looks like it might survive. We just want to see where the truck dies in this test. Oh, come on. Let's real time this. Oh, will it make it? Oh, I don't know. Come on. It keeps bottoming out over the bumps here. Now, the difference between the Gravel D and the Gravel ROAMER is the fact that it's the Gravel ROAMER is a lot heavier, and even though I think they're both all-wheel drive. Oh, and it survives. No radiator damage, probably some suspension damage and stuff like that. But let's switch over, switch vehicles. We're gonna start on a little bit of an angle because the ROAMER was on a little bit of an angle. 4 times slow motion. Yeah, I think this is just rear wheel drive, but we'll find out in a minute here. Oh. Now, also, the ROAMER has more support because it is a SUV. It has a better structure. The bed of the truck isn't as strong as something like, you know, a cab. Now, brake at the end like I did the ROAMER. All right, back to real time. Time to go through the mud. And it survives. It survives. Now, will it survive this horrible, horrible bumpy area here? All right, and also we're gonna judge the damage that it takes and stuff like that. So let's bring it down to 4 times slow motion. And oh, the first hit wasn't too bad. Oh, it's getting a little air. I think for damage wise though, I think the ROAMER is gonna win this one. Oh, maybe it is all wheel drive, but let's bring this back up to real time. Now it's just bottoming out. I think the ROAMER has a little bit of a lower ride height too. You can just hear the tailgate just smacking. Oh my god. Now, okay, do you know what? We're gonna have to give this one to the Gravel D, because damage wise, it looks a lot better. Probably drives a little bit better too. And the Roamer looks all smashed up and stuff. Like the front windshield smashed, the rear passenger side door smashed up and stuff like that. And plus the exhaust is hanging. So we're gonna give this one to the Gravel D. All right, guys. So we got another test here, and it's gonna be a speed / suspension test to see how fast it can go and how much damage it takes at the bottom of the hill. So that'd be kind of interesting to see. So let's start off with the Gravel D. All right. So gonna go in there. I know how we all like that slow motion. Oh, look at that beautiful slow motion. Only four times. I like to go really slow. Just so that I know that I have like the vehicle in the right spot. But we're getting up to 95, 96, 97 miles an hour. 98, well, we get up to 100, there's 100. Now let's see what we get at the bottom. So let's speed up a tiny bit. Also, let's see the damage it takes. 113, 114. Ooh, a lot of front end damage there. So it hit at 114. Now, speed up a tiny bit. Try and keep control of the vehicle here. And then try and come to a complete stop. Oh. Alright. So, it hit 114 miles an hour. Did about this much damage. No radiator damage, nothing like that. Nothing too serious. But let's switch over back. Alright, here we go. So, I kind of messed that one up because I went a little bit too fast going into here, so let's do this now and get some beautiful slow motion going. Oh, here we go. So we're getting up to 100, 8 times slow motion, and I think we're lined up with it. Here we go. So 111, 12, 13, 14, 15, 115 miles an hour. So 1 kilometer more. Now let's see. Oh, the radiator damage though. I might have to give this a point to the Gravel D. Let's see if we can stop it in time. Oh no. And plus, trying to keep this thing from sliding like this. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. Come on. Come to a stop. Real time. Alright. So, what we have here is radiator damage. Oh man, the door is all mangled. Everything's all mangled. Let's see if we could drive it over to the Gravel D here just to do a side-by-side comparison. So the radiator damage, more front end damage, the windshield shattered, and oh man. Alright, so let's go to the next test here. Alright guys, so we're gonna go over here to our next test, and this is the mudding course, I like to call it. But not only is it mud, right? Really, really deep mud, but also uphill, so it would make it kind of hard to catch grip and stuff like that. And these are just normal street tires here. So first off, we're going to start off with the Gravel D. I don't know if I have high hopes for this one, though. All right. Oh, no. And if one gets stuck, we got to see if which one makes it the farthest. Oh, no. Come on. Will it make it? I'm getting too close to the edge there. This might be it for the gravel. Nope. Okay, we keep going. This might be it for the Gravel D, though. No backing up, no nothing. So, I call this. No? Okay, hold on. Yeah, no, that's backing up. Alright. So, let's say right around. Let's try and get the truck kind of at the edge here. Just so that I can put the parking brake on so we don't lose where the truck was. Alright, so the Gravel D made it to about here. So let's switch vehicles to the Roamer and let's see how far the thing gets. I think this will make it a little bit farther because it has more weight to push down on it. I don't know. Because I'm not an off-road guy, right? I'm more of a on-road racing type of person. So let's get this started here. Oh, good start. All right. Going. And no reversing, obviously. Now here's where, here's where the Gravel D got stuck. Oh, wow, just plows right through there. All right, come on, full throttle. Now, this is what puts this at a slight disadvantage, right? Because before I didn't go full throttle, but I think that's going to be it. Yep. So, the Roamer wins this one because I hit the rocks and stuff like that. It could probably go farther, but for now, we're just gonna say this is the winner in this challenge. So, all right. So, here we are. Now this, I don't know how well this is gonna work, but it's gonna be the braking challenge to see, how fast, each vehicle can brake. So let's start off with the Gravel D. I don't have high hopes for this, but let's bring it into slow motion. So basically, we're going to use this kind of, alright, so there should be rocks down there. Yep. So once when we get past the rocks, full throttle, alright, or once when we see the rock, like, let's see here, it's hard to explain. But once we get past the rocks, or get to the rocks, we have to hit the brakes. So brake, we gotta see both brakes, parking brake and normal brake. Oh, will it stop? I don't think it's gonna stop. Oh no. And let's watch that beautiful slow motion. Oh wow. Just destroyed. Okay. So obviously that didn't work. So let's switch vehicles here to the Roamer. Alright. I have some pretty high hopes for this thing though. Hopefully, like, I think it has better tires. I'm not 100% sure, though. So here we go. Sorry, I got a message here. But alright, so we're not gonna hit the gas just yet. Kinda slow it down a tiny bit because I don't want it jumping too much. We want it to just, there we go. Now full throttle once when it gets stable enough. Once when it hits the rocks, it's braking time. Will it stop? Right about now. So both brakes are on. Will it stop? Oh no. It's only a... Okay. Come on. Oh, you can make it. You can make it. You can make it. Oh, it's not gonna make it. It's not. It's gonna... Oh, wait. Hold on. It's kind of getting sideways a bit. It might have a slight chance. Oh no, it's done. It's done. Oh no. Oh, that, wow. Just destroyed. Oh, okay, so. Wow. So obviously they both fail, so no one wins that challenge. So one more test I'd like to do is to see which one can take a hit. Alright. So we're going to set this one up at the bottom here. Which one can take the most damage from a vehicle hitting them. And we're going to use the roamer as a... Actually, no, wait. Better yet, I got a better vehicle for this. So, this would be our controlled smasher right now. Aw, man. I don't know how fast the thing can go, but it's about to hit. Alright. Hit the gravel D. So let's bring it into a little bit of slow motion here. Four times just to line it up. Oh, let's get first person view here. RPMs every 100. Wow. Okay, here we go. Oh no. Oh no, I feel like this is going to be really bad because it's going to hit at probably around 95, 96. Yeah, that's a head-on collision at 100. Holy crap, let's 16 times this. Wow. Alright, here we go. Oh! Switch vehicle to the pickup here. Wow. Now the drive shaft is still good. It just doesn't have a back tire. Wow, okay, let's... And it's on fire. So, well, it still drives. You can still drive it. Wow. While it's on fire. Okay, so... Now the roamer has to try and survive this. Alright. It has to try and beat this. This is too crazy. Alright. So the roamer is down there. Let's see if this can survive. So let's get into a little bit of slow motion again just to line it up. Now the semi-truck is kind of weird to drive, right? But it is a wrecking ball of a vehicle. Alright, so if the roamer can continue driving, right, after this, full throttle T-bone by a semi, I think, like, the gravel D is winning anyway, but for it to have, like, any sort of chance or anything like that, it needs to survive this. Oh. Crumpled. Crumpled seal skin. Let's go into the roamer, see what's all broken. So right now, wow, okay, so both the tires are destroyed, the door is destroyed, no engine damage, gas tank destroyed, but the gravel D was also had a broken gas tank. So let's full time. Wow. No, it has too many body panels. It's not gonna. Can't disconnect itself. I'm gonna turn that down a bit. Oh no. Okay, hold on. Maybe if we go to semi and then switch vehicles to roamer. All right. Oh my God. I think we have a winner here. Even though that both the tires on this side, yeah, both the tires here are flat, it has all four tires, or all four rims at least. Wow. So that's it, guys. If you guys like the video, hit that thumbs up. Oh, tires are popping over there. Hit that thumbs up. Really means a lot to me. Well, if you didn't like it, thumbs down. Sorry I yawned so much. Only had one coffee today, but hit that subscribe. Did I say that? I don't know. Who cares? Hit that subscribe button. Again. Three times, because if you hit it again, they'll unsubscribe. So subscribe to the channel. Hit that like button. And I'll see you guys next time.